Good morning, students. Today we'll be discussing about the chapter Sexual Reproduction in Flowering Plants. Topic for today is Formation of Fruit. The various objectives of today's topic are True Fruit, False Fruit, Parthenocarpic Fruit, Importance of Seed for the Development of Fruit, Functions of Fruit, Kinds of Fruit. Along with this, we'll be learning few terms such as Epicarp, Mesocarp, Endocarp and pomology. So we'll be starting with the topic now. A true fruit develops from a ripened ovary. As the seed develops, the ovary wall matures and forms a pericarp, and most of the floral parts wither away means falls off, and the fruit is a mature ovary containing seeds. The fruit wall, called the pericarp, is differentiated into three regions, namely epicarp, mesocarp, endocarp. Epicarp, it forms the outer skin. Mesocarp, it forms the middle fleshy part. And endocarp, it forms the innermost layer that protects the seed. In mango and coconut, the fruit is known as a drupe. A drupe is a fleshy fruit with thin skin and a central stone containing the seed. Example, mango, as we have already discussed, and even we can add cherry, almond. They basically develop from monocarpillary superior ovary and are one-seeded. As the name suggests, monocarpillary. Mono means one and carpillary means carpel. So that is the ovary containing single carpel. Superior ovary. Superior, also we can use the word hypogynous. It means all whorls are below ovary and ovary occupies highest position. In mango, the pericarp is differentiated into three distinct regions, the way we have started earlier, that is epicarp, the outer thin layer, mesocarp, that is the middle fleshy layer that we eat, and the innermost layer, that is endocarp. This image is clearly indicating the seed. And now this endocarp is providing protection to seed. In coconut, which is also a drupe, pericarp is differentiated into epicarp, mesocarp, endocarp. Here in this image it is clear. This is epicarp, which is the outer green cover. The middle, that is the fibrous cover, known as mesocarp. And the innermost layer, that is thick, stony, brown part, that is known as endocarp. And the edible portion of coconut, that means which we consume, is endosperm. Now we'll be discussing about false fruit. It is a fruit in which the pulpy, edible portion is not the wall of an ovary, but a floral part like receptacle or thalamus. In my previous lecture, I have already discussed about receptacle, that is a swollen cup-shaped structure present above the pedicel. Now, this receptacle forms the succulent fleshy structure, and the best example for false fruit is apple and strawberry. Here I have given two images to distinguish between a true fruit and a false fruit. So here this is the edible part, that is its flower parts fuse and swell. Now, another very important part, that is parthenocarpic fruit. It is a fruit that develops without fertilization. Best example of parthenocarpic fruits are oranges, watermelon. Even I have shown the diagram here to distinguish between all these. Here we can talk about papaya, kiwi. These fruits are being cultivated for experiments by horticulturists. These varieties are generally seedless or have non-viable seeds. The very important term which is to be introduced, that is pomology. It is a branch of horticulture that deals with the study of fruits and their cultivation. Next, what is the importance of seed for the development of fruit? Pollination brings about number of changes in the ovary. It prevents abscission of the ovary. Abscission here means breaking away of ovary. Pollen grains as well as the carpillary tissue secretes auxin. Auxin is a plant growth regulator. which is necessary for fertilization and initial growth of an ovary. After fertilization, as a seed grows, it synthesizes auxins and another plant growth hormone such as gibberellin, cytokinin. These plant growth hormones or plant growth regulators help in the further development of an ovary into a fruit. Cells undergo a number of mitotic divisions, growth and differentiation, forming the pulp of the fruit, which is the edible portion. An ovary undergoes a manifold increase in size. The best example here is pumpkin. An ovary grows 20 times in 2 weeks. Now, another topic, that is functions of fruit. So, various functions are performed by fruit, such as it is a source of food energy for animals. It is a source of many chemicals like sugars, pectin, organic acids, vitamins and minerals. It protects the seed from unfavorable climatic conditions and animals, helps in dispersal of seeds to distant places, and in few cases, fruit may provide nutrition to the developing seedling. Kinds of fruit. There are basically 3 kinds of fruit: simple fruit, aggregate fruit, and multiple fruit. Now, talking about simple fruit, it is a fruit which is derived from a single ovary or a compound ovary of a single flower. It could be further divided into 2 fleshy or succulent fruits, and the second type is dry fruits, which are further divided into dehiscent and indehiscent fruits. Here I have shown the image to talk about fleshy fruits. As the diagram shows, it is apple here, tomato, pear, strawberries, and dry fruits such as chilgoza and all. So here, difference is there between dry fruit and fleshy fruit. Dry fruits, they are normally grey, brown or a dull color, while fleshy fruits, they are normally juicy and brightly colored. They can be of different types. Dry fruit such as nuts, which are hard shelled, grains, one seeded fruits of grasses and cereals, legume, and the best example here they have given, that is peas. Fleshy fruits such as cucumber, blueberry, tomatoes, they can be of different types, such as drupe, which is simple fruit, one seeded with an outer fleshy layer, and berry, which is having thin covering with seeds embedded in flesh. Now, next is aggregate fruit. There are a number of copies of a single flower that develops independently to form fruits. The fruit is a clump of many simple fruits having a common base. And the examples are blackberries, raspberries, and even strawberries. Now, we'll be talking about multiple fruit. These types of fruits, they develop from an inflorescence. This fruit is formed from the single ovary of many flowers joined together. Example is pineapple and mulberry. Mulberry means shahtoot. So here, different kinds of fruits are mentioned in this chart form, like fleshy fruits, drupe, we have already discussed. Example, mango, coconut, peach, berries such as tomato, grape, brinjal, pepo, example cucumber. Then we are talking about next category, that are dry fruits, which includes legumes. Under dehiscent dry fruits, legumes such as pea, bean, silicua, such as candy tuft, mustard, capsules such as ladyfinger, dhatura. Another category is indehiscent dry fruits such as caryopsis, example wheat, rice, maize, cipsela, dandelion, sunflower, nut such as cashew nut, samara such as fruits of ash tree. Thank you. We'll continue in the next lecture.